Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's take a look at the new Privacy Report feature in Safari 14. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So after you upgrade to Safari 14, you're going to see a new button at the top of the screen for a Privacy Report. Let's go to a website and then you'll see that button come alive. If you click it, you'll see a number there, usually a pretty large number for most websites, of the number of trackers prevented from profiling you. You can click here to reveal the list and see a list of all these sites, sites you've never heard of, and sites that certainly aren't the one that you're visiting right now. So let's go to another site, like say Yahoo, and then we can click here and see a number for that and a new set of sites. Now you may see some sites that are the same between different pages. And in fact, if you click the I here, you get a full report of the number of trackers stopped in the last 30 days, the percentage of sites you visited that had trackers on them, and lists of websites including all of the trackers that have been seen on those websites. And then you can also do the list by trackers and then see the sites for each tracker. Now the good news is all of these trackers have been prevented from tracking you. And that's because in Safari Preferences, there's a feature under Privacy, Prevent Cross-Site Tracking. And as long as you have that turned on, that report's actually showing you the trackers that have been stopped. So what is a tracker? Well, when you're at a site like this one, you may think that everything you see here is from that website. So this is Yahoo.com, and you may think everything here is Yahoo.com. But that's not true. There are parts of the page that are from another website, like this advertisement over here. So the ad is basically a blank rectangle on the web page, and it's filled in by another web page coming from that advertiser. So any ads you see on a website are not coming from that site. They're just a reserved spot, and another site comes in and fills in that space. That's how web advertising works. So you're not just looking at this site, not just looking at Yahoo.com here. You're actually looking at Yahoo.com and, in this case, 14 other sites. These are the 14 other sites that you're also viewing, either in rectangles like the ones for ads, or as hidden little pieces of code. Those hidden pieces of code are loaded onto the web page and they are trackers. Now sometimes trackers do nothing more than actually gather statistics. So the website owner may want to know how many people are visiting that site every day, and a tracker is simply going to be used to count that. So they can see, like, today 800 people came to their site and tomorrow 900 people came to their site, so traffic's increasing. Tracker will be stored there so it doesn't count you twice. You visit the page once and it counts you as one user, and it doesn't count you multiple times during that day. Other trackers, though, are noting the content of the page. So if you're at a travel page, it will note that you are interested in travel. If you're at a page about buying a car, it'll note that you're interested in buying a car. It'll then take this information and use it to serve ads when you're at other pages. So looking at some of these, like for instance DoubleClick.net here is one of Google's ad services, and DoubleClick.net is seen almost on every page that serves ads. So if you're looking at a page that has to do with a topic and you go to then another website, both of them are using DoubleClick.net, and the ads could be customized based on the interest you've shown in topics as you've gone from website to website. This isn't inherently bad. It doesn't really know who you are or really much about you. It just knows that at one point you were interested in buying a new car or finding a cheap airfare. And now instead of showing you a random ad, it's going to show you an ad tailored to those interests. But fortunately, thanks to this feature here to prevent cross-site tracking in Safari, these are prevented. Safari is recognizing that an advertising company is trying to track you from page to page, and it's stopping that. So when you go to a new page, you may still see an ad that fits a previous topic to another page that you viewed, but it won't be because of a tracker like this. Of course, if you're voluntarily logged into a system, like say you're logged into Facebook and you view certain topics on Facebook, and then you go to another part of Facebook or a website that uses Facebook in some way and you see an ad, well, that's going to be able to track you because you've been logged into Facebook that entire time. You're giving your information to that system that you're logged into. That's not a web browser cross-site tracker. That's actually a tracker inside of the system you're logged into. So while this privacy report is interesting and it does keep websites honest, showing you exactly what trackers they're using, it's really not something to get alarmed about. Cross-site tracking has been around for a long time, and advertisers are always going to try to find ways to customize ads so they don't waste their money. They don't want to show you an ad about a service you're not interested in. And on the other hand, they want to make sure if somebody is interested in their services that those advertisements reach them. It's nice to see this as a prominent feature in Safari to bring attention to internet privacy, but there's really no action for you to take other than to have this feature turned on. Although it will probably have the effect in the future of advertisers and advertising networks using trackers less and less. But it's doubtful that this will happen in other browsers outside of Safari and also Firefox, as a browser like Chrome is owned by Google, and Google of course has an interest in serving up relevant ads, as ads are their primary source of revenue. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.